Are you about to start medicine or you're already in med school, but getting bogged down by all the information out there about what textbooks to get, to anki or to not anki? So in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the best resources out there, from textbooks to websites to the best YouTube gurus that I found super helpful when I was a new medical student like you. And I promise it won't break your back either. Hi everyone, my name is Eunice and I'm a junior doctor working in Christchurch Hospital in New Zealand. I remember the first few weeks of studying med school was super terrifying, mostly because the difficulty of the content escalated from level 1 to 100 real quick. But like, the professors still gave their lectures on day 1 and expected you to somehow like understand and absorb everything. I've been in that boat before and it doesn't feel very good. So that's why I've compiled a list of no bullshit resources to help you get started. Keep watching to the end, because at the end of the video, I'm going to give you my top 3 tips on how to best use these study resources to crush your exams. So let's get started. All right, starting up with websites. UpToDate is a very, very in-depth Bible of medicine. It's got anything and everything, basically. And everything is evidence-based and updated super regularly. And even my senior consultants go here if they had a specific question that they wanted to answer. There is, however, a subscription fee, though, that your hospital or university might give you free access to this. Anki or Quizlet. This is a great way to learn content with spaced repetition / active recall. And this method is pretty much gold standard for memorizing information, and that's evidence-based. So what you do with Anki is that you create your own deck with the information from your lecture slides. It can be pretty time-consuming to make Anki flashcards, though, just because of the sheer volume of content there is with each lecture. But you need to be pretty careful to not overdo on Anki, because it can just be so easy to like use every sentence from your lecture slide and insert it into Anki. That's not necessary, and you'll burn out. What you can do, though, is use existing flashcard banks like Zanki, which is based on USMLE. Pass Medicine. It's an amazing website that offers a variety of courses, from med school finals to MRCP exams for registrars. They can be a lot harder, though, in terms of the questions they ask compared to the exams. And these are MCQ questions, which are pretty clinically relevant. And they'll tell you a little bit more about the condition when you do finish answering the question. Does come at a price, but it's not too expensive and it's totally worth it. I use it as my main study tool leading up to my 5th year exams. ECGs. Life in the fast lane. ECGs are definitely the death of me, and this was a great website that explains ECGs pretty well and have lots of quizzes that test your knowledge of ECGs. Radiopedia. It's a good radiology website and has a huge gallery of different x-rays, CTs and ultrasounds and how to interpret them. Geeky Medics. It's a good OSCE revision site and they have good resources on how to take a history, how to examine a patient and education stations as well. This is amazing because they have videos demonstrating exactly what you should do. It's pretty gold standard stuff because sometimes you learn from your clinical skills teacher and it's just not super clear. It can be pretty hard to learn anatomy in medical school. It was one of my weakest subjects because I'm a visual learner and anatomy is all about seeing it visually. So that's why I found Acklands as a really great resource for anatomy, because they are based on videos of cadavers and they label different structures and you can see them very visually. Complete Anatomy app is also really helpful. It's a 3D anatomy app of the human body and it's all labeled. I use this a lot before my anatomy labs because I'll just want to find out about something, like I'll type in laryngeal nerve or something and it will just go straight and zooms into the 3D model to identify exactly where it is. YouTube videos. There are great medical YouTube videos out there that does amazing teaching and it condenses your lectures. Your lecture is like 1 hour teaching to a very easy to understand 15 minute video. Good examples of this are Khan Academy, Osmosis, and also a Amando Hasudangan. I hope I pronounced that right. These three are my go-to YouTube channels because the things that they actually teach you are pretty accurate because the rest of YouTube might not be as reliable. All right, last but not least, textbox. I don't use textbox as my main study resource, but it's really good for finding information that are specific. And then after that, you should just put it away. Because the thing about textbooks is that it encourages you to learn every single thing in the way of the chapter is laid out, which is not right. I mean, it's nice to sort of bring a textbook to the library to flex that you're a medical student, but otherwise, I really wouldn't be using them as a main study tool. There were a couple of textbooks that I use regularly during medical school, and I like to recommend them to you. The only thing that I have to say that is you can actually download these PDFs for free to save you some monies. So the first one is Robin's Pathology. It's a great pathology resource. There's lots of purple and pink diagrams, and it goes through the pathophysiology in a lot of depth. Actually, most of the lecture slides contents actually come out from this textbook. The second one is Gray's Anatomy. It's got really good images and lots of clinical relevance and cases and things. For example, like if they go through like carpal bones, for example, they would have a clinical case area where they discuss the importance of identifying a scaphoid fracture because of risk of avascular necrosis. So that's pretty relevant. The next one is Netta's flashcards. These are great handy flashcards for anatomy, and it basically sort of asks you what it is, and it's all labeled, and on the back of it comes with the answers and the clinical relevance here, and it comes in a binder, which is pretty handy. USMLE First Aid. This was my favorite textbook, and I've got lots of memories of it. This is best for revising for fifth year exams or step 2 USMLE exams in the UK. It's got lots of high yield condensed material at a glance, and it's sort of formatted in like history, exam and treatment, and sort of assumes that you already understand the content, so it's by no means like a comprehensive textbook. The next one here is Oxford Handbook of Clinical Medicine, this yellow book. It's a quick, good summary handbook of everything you need to know in medicine. It's more clinically based though, so it's good for clinical rotations. It's not that helpful if you're still in early medical years. A lot of people have carried this in their little handbags on ward rounds and like whipped them out to try and look studious. So as promised, I'll be sharing with you my three tips on how to use these study resources while you're in med school. So tip number one, during the first few years of med school, i.e. your preclinical years, all you really need is actually just your course materials. The additional study resources that I've recommended are good for if you're stuck, you don't understand a topic, or you really just want to bulk up your learning a little bit more. So don't go buying all the textbooks, downloading all the apps and websites initially because of FOMO, because like even a textbook, they can like cost you like hundreds of dollars. So maybe just try download the free PDFs first. And if you thought that they were helpful, then you can go purchase a textbook later. It's not too late. Then tip number two, when you're in your clinical years, you actually spend most of your time learning clinical information while on the wards when you're seeing the patients, not from textbooks and all these resources. You're hardly using textbooks while you're in these clinical years. You would use a lot of hospital guidelines when you're answering questions anyway. Tip number three, when you were prepping for your final year exams, which is USMLE step 2 exams for the rest of you guys, that's when I'll start using these bad boys. Actually, towards the end of my exam prep, I was just using PassMed, Anki and USMLE step 2 for the core of my study. I hope that was useful information, and obviously there are heaps more of good resources out there, but ultimately I think it comes down to trial and error of what sort of resources that you click with. It'll be cool to see what you thought was the most helpful for you in med school, so comment below. And if that video was helpful, make sure to like and subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks guys, see you later.